I just know Jordan Poole throwing the biggest temper tantrum right now. He gotta be fuming. If I was him, I would be breaking everything in sight trying to get my lick back on Draymond before I got shipped out. And it's hilarious because this man had already unfollowed him on Insta. So earlier today in a trade that absolutely no one saw coming, the Washington Wizards traded CP0 rings to the Golden State Warriors for Jordan Poole, Ryan Rollins, and some picks. And if we being honest, don't nobody care about the other pieces Washington got. So this trade was essentially just CP3 for Jordan Poole. I kid you not, like straight up, my first reaction was what the absolute fuck. Bob Myers stepped down as Golden State's GM and the whole front office got to wildin'. But when you really think about it, I can understand why Golden State went ahead and made this move. Well, it's just my assumption anyways. Draymond is a big part of the reason the Warriors got so much championship success. And even before the season was over, there were talks about if he was gonna re-sign or not. And I would be really surprised if the Warriors just let him walk. A few days ago, Draymond declined his player option and opted to be an unrestricted free agent so he could get a better contract. But before the season even started, the Warriors signed Jordan Poole to that 4-year, $128 million max deal. And I mean, it's a no-brainer. They already got Steph and Klay on max deals too. There's only so much money you can give up before hitting the cap, and you gotta make sure you have enough to sign the rest of the roster too. Poole's contract was eating up a lot of cap space, and it didn't help that this season he was on the court hooping like Drewski. Like, yeah, he had his moments, but for the most part, he was straight buns. He was looking like a superstar before he signed that contract, but as soon as he did, he started putting up tour dates on the stat line. Finesse the fuck out of Golden State. And pending some crazy bounce back season by JP, this gonna be the second biggest finesse in NBA history. Larsa Pippen for sure got that first place spot by a landslide the way she did Scotty. Hey, Scotty, you ain't deserve that, my boy. City boy's down atrocious after this one.
She belongs to the streets.
That punch by Draymond was really a canon event for the Warriors. Jordan Poole gotta be mad. Getting traded for the same dude that faded you? Nah, you gotta spin the block, gangy. And on top of that, he finna be in Washington, D.C. Last time I checked, one no baddies in DC, so it ain't gonna be no little shorty sitting courtside to make him play better. We might as well subtract 20 from all this nigga's stats right now. Even Kyle Kuzma had Winnie Harlow going between Cali and DC, so JP finna be in the trenches. Instead of being at red carpet movie premieres with baddies, they finna have Jordan Poole on the front lines at freedom marches. I'm really interested to see how this Warriors offense gonna look like though, with both Steph and CP3 being both ball dominant guards. Maybe like a 3-guard rotation with Steph playing off the ball more? See, I don't know. We'll have to see, especially if they do end up re-signing Draymond. But hey, remember to like the video, follow your boy on Insta, and sub on YouTube. Link in bio.